Welcome to Bar India News Hour. Digital consumers to accelerate 2022 with growing economy. There is a prime focus on digital users as they emerge from the COVID-19 pandemic into a post-pandemic next normal. The mainstreaming of IoT, artificial intelligence and big data analytics is providing utilities with the firepower of working and transforming into modern enterprises. The unprecedented adoption of e-utilities has already charged up the digital space. Cryptocurrencies, unicorns, decacorns, IPOs, super apps, data breaches have become a part of drawing room conversations in 2021, a year when India's digital economy boomed. Several important pending bills and policies across data protection, cryptocurrencies, e-commerce and social media intermediaries were fast-tracked. A lot of this was driven by an unprecedented digital adoption of payments, e-commerce, social media, healthcare, education, remote working and every other possible utility. In 2022, the digital economy will continue its upward journey, propelled by the listing frenzy of internet startups towards the end of 2021. The listings have boosted investor confidence in the internet economy space. Developing countries such as Brazil, India, and Mexico have seen higher growth in digital adoption than developed ones have during the past 6 months, which may reflect a catching-up effect since developed countries were further ahead in their pace of digitization and in the percentage of adults with internet access. It follows that developed countries may see a deceleration in digital adoption sooner than developing countries will. In India, the digital economy gained speed, regulations arrived, and we are likely to see more rules governing the space. But an area of concern are overlaps, and experts feel these need to be streamlined. The draft bill focusing on personal data protection now includes social media intermediaries, which could also fall under the new IT rules. An expert from IndiaTech.org says, last 3 years of our efforts with SEBI and the government finally took shape in 2021 with the listing of Indian startups in India. 2 years ago, we had predicted that once this is triggered, we will see an exponential surge from the average $8 to $10 billion fund inflow into startups to a range of $30 to $40 billion as we are seeing now. Another expert says the year 2022, India could surpass China in terms of aggregate unicorns. On a quarter-to-quarter basis, we are already neck-to-neck with China in adding new unicorns and will soon surpass their aggregate number. A similar overlap will be seen when the new e-commerce rules comes into play. Going forward, 2022 is going to witness the implementation of 5G. The fifth generation wireless technology offers the greatest transformative power to ensure that the fourth industrial revolution realizes its full potential through its unprecedented connectivity capability. It will give further impetus to the growth of the digital economy in 2022. We can anticipate an acceleration of 5G millimeter wave deployments in urban and densely populated environments alongside continued rollouts of low-band 5G expansions into rural markets. Let's look into today's headlines in Bar India. UPI servers back to normal after a brief blackout. The Unified Payment Interface services were restored following a brief outage due to an intermittent technical glitch. The National Payments Corporation of India shared an update on social media after users reported an outage that lasted for around an hour. Several users had reported on Twitter that the UPI server was down and they were not being able to make any transactions using digital wallets and online payment platforms such as Google Pay and Paytm. SP Kochar says no scope for more than three telcos in India. Cellular Operators Association of India Director General SP Kochar said that there is no scope for new entrants as the Indian telecom market is adequate for three players now. He further added that the Indian telecom market has reached its consolidation stage and thus there is no space for other operators. The Raspberry Pi is trained to detect malware attacks using electromagnetic waves. The Raspberry Pi malware detection system relies on electromagnetic waves emerging from the potential victim's computer to detect malicious activities. Researchers claim the system achieved accuracy as high as 99.82% during testing. The malware detection system does not intercept any software or investigate data packets flowing in and out of any computer. Instead, the Raspberry Pi estimates with a surprisingly high degree of accuracy ongoing malware activity by analyzing specific electromagnetic waves. RBL Bank partners with Google for next-gen customer service. RBL Bank and Google announced a strategic collaboration to fuel the bank's customer experience strategy and expand its value proposition to serve its rapidly growing customer base through its digital platform Abacus 2.0. This collaboration will enable better customer data management and analytics, enabling effective cross-selling within the bank's large customer base and subsequently reducing the cost of customer acquisition significantly. KEC International bags new order of ₹1,025 crores. Engineering, procurement and construction major KEC International has bagged new orders worth ₹1,025 crores across its various businesses for projects in India and the Middle East. The other businesses from which the company has bagged orders include oil and gas, pipelines and smart infrastructures. Its civil business has also secured an order for infrastructure works in the metals and mining segment in India. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. You can download the War India app from Google Play Store and Apple App Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.